Hello, my name is Mark Hasselbeck, and welcome to our presentation of Shape from Caustics, reconstruction of 3D printed glass from simulated caustic images. To motivate our problem, let's have a look at the 3D printing process in which a glass fiber is melted onto a base substrate. This process produces print lines, which are already useful in optics applications such as on-substrate waveguides. More complex structures can be formed by layering these lines as in other deposition-based printing processes. On the right, you can see a photo of the process as conducted by our partners. Finding optimal process parameters for this process is still an open problem. Right now, process feedback happens by taking the sample out of the machine and putting it into a measurement device such as a surface profilometer or a confocal microscope. Such a process delivers high-quality results, but is time-consuming and not scalable to serial production. We wish to address these problems with a new approach that is easily integratable into already existing production equipment. For this, we wish to add a simple light source and an imaging screen into the machine framework. Starting from the light source, we trace rays through the scene and onto the screen. This formulation of image formation as a Monte Carlo process allows us to process fairly general scenes with multiple refractions as well as multiple wavelengths. The resulting on-screen brightness distribution is called a caustic. The difference between simulated and measured caustic is back propagated to the height field by our differentiable caustic renderer. In conjunction with further regularization, this can be used in any number of gradient-based optimization approaches. Our work shares similarities with recent work in caustic design. That is, they too have as input one caustic image and as output a generating shape. However, different to us, caustic design has a very different objective, in that an arbitrary manufacturable shape is a valid solution. This usually leads to solutions with gentle curvature that can be quite far from the intended generating shape. It already shows that the reconstruction problem from a single view is highly ill-posed. We address this by carefully choosing regularization terms that are specific to the glass 3D printing problem. We use four regularization terms. In order, these are: first, sparsity in pixel bases. That is, we search for solutions with few non-zero coefficients in the pixel bases. Second, lower and upper physical bounds of the printed material. Since we know the thickness of the substrate and the filament used for printing, we can enforce upper and lower physical bounds on the deposited material. Third, enforcing of printing area. As the production is executed on a machine tool with known excess accuracy, we let the user provide masks of the printed area such that material is only deposited inside of the marked area. Fourth, conservation of volume. Since the total amount of deposited material can be easily inferred from the length of printed filament, we enforce conservation of set volume. Since this penalty term remains elusive to establish in our reconstruction scheme, we employ a heuristic to enforce volume conservation. The main idea is to enforce a slow growth of the volume at the beginning and at the end. That is, when there is no deposited volume present and when the desired volume has been nearly reached. In between those states, already established features will experience enhanced growth. Here, you can see some results of our ablation experiments. A baseline reconstruction using gradient descent produces spurious features and even estimates the optimal surface below the starting surface. This reconstruction with sparsity and physical and area bounds already works quite well, as it shows less artifacts. And when enabling the volume conservation heuristic, the relative error of the reconstruction is in the order of the noise level. Finally, when using three distinct wavelengths for the reconstruction, even the smallest line feature can be reconstructed at 20% noise level to some extent. Another point these algorithms influence is the runtime of each method. Here, you can see that the baseline optimization takes the most time, both with 162 iterations and 6.62 minutes until our stopping criterion is fulfilled. The line viewer scheme without volume heuristic takes 114 iterations and 4.72 minutes. And with the volume heuristic, the runtime is positively influenced with 72 iterations and 2.95 minutes respectively. The reconstruction with three wavelengths takes 33 iterations and has a runtime of 2.98 minutes. We conduct further experiments in the presence of additional optical elements in the path of the light. We demonstrate the general applicability of our simulation and reconstruction framework, which was formulated in this way to be able to adapt to disruptive factors inside the machine tool. This means that optical elements, which might be necessary in the future or are already present, such as the reflective barrel of the focusing lengths, can be incorporated into the reconstruction simply by modeling them as part of the scene. Finally, we conduct a real-world experiment on the sample from the production process. Our simple transmission setup is shown here. As a light source, we use a flash with a color filter and a diffusion dome that was placed 15 centimeters from the substrate. Although far from perfect, we approximate this as a monochrome point light source in our virtual scene for reconstruction. The caustic is then taken from a semi-transparent paper diffusion screen onto which the lens is focused. Despite the difficulty in calibration with such a non-rigid setup, we are able to get a reasonable approximation of the printed line that might already be useful in the assessment continuity errors in the produced shape. Nevertheless, Further modeling, such as a transmission model, which takes the roughness of the glass substrate into account, as well as a more rigid setup, are necessary before we can deploy this method in production. Finally, when fixing the light source to the motion system of the machine tool, we might be able to improve the reconstruction with multiple light positions by potentially constraining the problem better and reducing the number of needed penalty terms. Thank you for your attention.